and communication in the teaching learning process. Because here whatever we are discussing, we have to focus that from the classroom perspective, isn't it? So we have to focus from thus that perspective only. So that part we have seen. Some of you were asking yesterday that, sir, how many classes are already held, because some of you have joined this program with some late. For the information of those people, we have not, especially in my paper, I have not covered so many things in this paper, and whatever I have already discussed in a very nutshell, I am repeating it once again. So it will give you opportunity to learn what is already discussed. And those who are the old student, means those who were present in those classes, it will be also be helpful for them to revise the concept and ask me question. Because that time very few people used to ask the question and respond the question raised by me. So this time you may ask question. So those who have joined little bit late, so there is absolutely no problem, because I am repeating those things, but it is little bit in the brief manner. It is not that much detail, but you will not miss which is very much essential. I will request, please mute your microphone, because it creates some disturbance in between. So when you are talking something with me, that time you unmute and talk with me, and again mute it. Anna, please mute your microphone. Okay. This is the one thing. Another thing that I would like to say you that, after end of this class, not this, every class, the recording of this class will be shared with you, means it will be uploaded over the YouTube, and then the link will be shared with you, so that those who are unable to attend the class or listen it properly because of the network issue, because I know that there is a network issue in some places. Itisri, can you mute your microphone, please? Okay. So those who are unable to attend the class or listen me properly, they can see the whole classroom recording, which will be uploaded in the YouTube, as well as it will be, the link will be shared with you in the learning platform for which I am collecting your details. I have shared one Google form. So I think 26 or 27 of you have responded. Others are also requested to fill the detail as soon as possible, so that we can begin with that platform. That is a very wonderful platform, and when I will begin, then I will be orienting about that also. Why I am doing all those things? Because when we talk about the ICT and educational technology, it is not a theoretical part. So theoretically I may talk so many big things, but it is not going to help you. What will be actually helping you when you will practice, when you will be using those things? So this is the one of the step to make you familiar with the LMS, learning management system, and Moodle is a very famous and a popular learning management system throughout the world. One reason is that it is a free and open source software. Do you know what is the free and open source software? Do you know? I have a.
No, sir. No, sir.
फॉस इसको बोलते हैं सॉफ्टवेयर शॉर्टकट में, एंड फुल में बोलते हैं फ्री एंड फ्री एंड ओपन सोर्स सॉफ्टवेयर. सो वी विल वी कैन डिस्कस इट लेटर ऑन ऑल्सो इफ यू आर नॉट नोइंग. Okay, because all those things I am required to discuss in the unit 1. So, that time I will discuss. Meanwhile, you can also search over the internet. Okay. What is the free and open source software? So, let us come to the point now. In the yesterday, we have seen the ICT and educational technology, wherein we have seen that when we talk about the educational technology, it constitutes the hardware part, software part, okay, then the theory part, theory and the practices. It includes both. Why it includes both? That already we have discussed. So, in the next we will see the communication. What is the basics of communication? It may be a little bit boring for the older student, but be with me, because my point is to make you understand and no one should be left out. Okay. So, when we talk about the communication, communication is a process. What kind of a process? It is a process by which we transfer our conceptual understanding about a phenomena or object to someone else. We communicate, we transfer. For sake of example, like that now I am talking about on the topic communication. So there is a something conceptual understanding in my mind. Some understanding I have about the topic that I want to make you understand. So how I will make you understand? Because there is no possibility till now that we can connect my mind to your mind and transfer it. There is no such technology available. Like that we transfer the file from the computer to the pen drive or something else. Sorry, just wait 1 minute. I have to plug in the computer because its battery is draining. Just 1 minute. Okay, sorry for the disturbance in between. Computer was not charged. So, I was talking about that there is no such technology is available by which I can transfer my knowledge and understanding and the thought to you. Like we transfer a file from a computer to the pen drive or any storage devices. We used to transfer, but there is no such technology is available for the human transferring from one mind to another mind. So how we can make you understand? how we can transfer the things. It is through the communication. Means whatever the idea I have, that I will communicate to you. You will get that idea and try to understand. But how this whole process goes? The first and foremost thing is that whenever we try to communicate, or better to say that exchange of idea, because some idea I have in my mind, that's I am trying to make you understand. So I am exchanging my idea. So how the exchange of the idea will happen? It will require some medium. Some medium is required. You can think of that. You have a overhead water tank at the roof of your house, and you want a water in a bathroom bucket kept in the bathroom. So how the water will come from that overhead water tank kept on a roof to the bucket in the bathroom? It will require some medium, channel through which the water can come to your bucket. Without that, it can never happen. So when talk in this fashion, is exchanging of idea also requires some sort of a medium. Without a medium, the exchange can never happen. Like that, if you are sitting in front of me, I can talk, you can listen. The medium is the air by which the vibration of a sound is going on and you are receiving. Now, when we talk about what is the medium, then the electromagnetic signals are the medium. Because whatever I am speaking here, that is received by this microphone. This microphone and this whole device is converting the physical vibrations of a sound to an electromagnetic signal, and that signal is traveling through a wire or sometimes wireless medium also, and through that it is reaching to you, and then the other process is happening that we will also discuss. So one of the thing is required is that the medium. Without a medium, it can never happen. For sake of example, you are sitting at your home, okay, and there is a no call. I am not doing the Google Meet or no phone call, no video call, nothing else. You are at a home. For sake of example, someone is in the Cuttack. I am speaking here. Whether the person is in Cuttack will be able to listen my voice? Definitely no. Why? You may say that, sir, when I am sitting in a classroom and you are also sitting in a classroom, then I am able to listen. What is the medium? Air is a medium. So from here to Cuttack also air is a medium. So why I cannot listen? Because in this medium there is a restriction also. It cannot travel such a long distance. Like that, I am staying in Niladri, Bihar. I can come to our department by foot also. I am coming by scooty, but I can come by foot also. But if you will tell that I am staying in a Cuttack and come to a department on a regular basis to attend a class, attend an office, it is not possible. You cannot come regularly. Or if you are very far, suppose that Raurkela, you cannot come once also. However, the funny thing is that during this lockdown, people has traveled a long distance by foot. That is another story. So there is a requirement of a medium. Without medium, the exchange of idea cannot happen. Medium is required. And as per the requirement, media must be appropriate. How appropriateness? Suppose that I am talking in the class, you are sitting in the class. So, I can speak and you can listen my voice. There is absolutely no problem. But if the class is so much big, suppose that of auditorium, if I will speak, you will not able to listen. So, what is required? That time, voice amplification device is required. Means some speaker, microphone, sound box, that kind of a thing, which can amplify my voice so that the person sitting in the last corner of the hall can also listen my voice. That is required. But in this case, this will again also not work. Here it is required to have some arrangement by which the communication means whatever I am speaking that can travel such a long distance without any distortion. अब ये बात आता है कि what is the distortion then? Distortion is a phenomena which creates a disturbance, which disturbs the propagation of a signal. Suppose that I am speaking here and there is a big hall. You can also listen to some extent my voice, but other voice will be there because some people will be talking, someone will be laughing, someone will be sneezing, someone will be coughing. So my voice will be not enough audible to understand. So these are the disturbance. During the old time or this time also, you will find that sometime when you are calling someone over a phone or a mobile phone, some background noise is too much. And that's why you are unable to listen what the other is saying and you are unable to understand. So this is the kind of a distortion which disturbs, and if there is a significant amount of a distortion, then it is a difficult to exchange the idea. So there is a one distortion. Let us now come to the different aspect of a communication. One aspect we have seen that in order to exchange the idea, a medium is required. What kind of a medium? Which has a very less distortion. Distortion should not be there. If there is a distortion, then it is a difficult to understand. What are the other things? Now see the systematically. See, I am speaking here about the process of communication. What is communication? I am speaking. How I am speaking? It is not like that whatever is coming in my mouth and you are listening. So whatever is coming, just I am speaking at random. No. It is not like that. Even it doesn't happen anytime. Even when you also speak, it is not like that whatever came, you spoke. बिफोर स्पीकिंग देर इज अ कॉन्सेप्चुअलाइजेशन. सपोज दैट आई एम हियर टॉकिंग अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. सो समथिंग आई एम कॉन्सेप्चुअलाइजिंग इन माई माइंड. सिस्टमैटिकली आई अरेंजिंग है ना वॉट आई हैव टू स्पीक. दैट कॉन्सेप्चुअलाइजेशन एंड अरेंजमेंट इज हैपनिंग इन माई माइंड. यू मे नॉट समटाइम रिकॉग्नाइज दैट यू आर कॉन्सेप्चुअलाइजिंग एंड अरेंजिंग हिट बिफोर स्पीकिंग बिकॉज इट हैपन्स सो क्विकली स्पॉन्टेनियसली. इट्स लाइक दैट यू हैव पुट द स्विच एंड लाइट इज ग्लोइंग, बल्ब इज ग्लोइंग. इवन इट हैपन्स मच मोर फास्टर दैन दैट. When you put a switch on of electric bulb glows. Even it has some duration between that, in the millisecond. But it happens more quickly than that. You can recognize that when you will be asked something, and you are not very much sure. We are not very much confident about that. So you will think, acha, this is the question, so what I have to reply, and then sometime you will think, and then you will organize, and then you will start speaking. Have you noticed this kind of a phenomena in your life? How many of you have experienced this kind of a phenomena, that when someone is asking to you, you have to think for a while, and after thinking you will be able to respond? How many of you have come across this kind of a phenomena?
That me.
Achha, only you, Ravi Shankar?
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
I think most of you. Isn't it? So, this is happening in my mind also. But since I am confident, so it is happening so quickly. And for you also, it happens so quickly that you are unable to recognize. And even after organizing it, Anna, it is not like that we start speaking. We choose a appropriate code. What is this code? This code is by which you communicate, like that I am speaking. So I am using a verbal code. Hai na? I am using a verbal code because sound is coming. Sound form of a code I am using. If I am required to write, like that just now I have typed FOSS, and the full form of a FOSS, free and open source software. I have chosen a alphabetical code, alphabets, written code. This is the verbal code, that is the written code. When I am talking to you, it is not like that I am sitting like this and I am talking like a robot. No. What I am doing? I am using my gesture, postures, verbal expression, voice modulation. If you will speak at a same pace, same pitch, your talk will not be effective. You have to modulate the voice. Sometime if you are emphasizing, you have to make it louder. We used to do. It is not like that I am talking, which is out of the practice. Everyone used to do. If we are sad, so our voice is low. The kind of a voice that you use when you are sad or when you are happy, do you use same kind of a voice? There is a difference. And by your voice, I can recognize that whether you are speaking in a sad mood or a happy mood. So these all are the codes by which we communicate each other, by which we communicate. So when the concepts are coming, conceptualization is done, we choose appropriate code. Even the verbal, I am speaking in the English. If you don't know English and I will start speaking in English, for sake of example, I think very few of you must be knowing the Malayalam, or I think none of you may be knowing Malayalam. Do you know Malayalam?
No, sir.
Acha. If I will start speaking in the Malayalam, then what will happen? For I don't know Malayalam, that is a secondary thing. But if I will start speaking in the Malayalam, what will happen?
We will not be able to understand.
So if you will not able to understand, then there is no point of talking me. If you are not understanding, then why I will talk? There is no point of talking.
Yes, sir.
If there is no point of talking, means there is no exchange of idea is happening.
Yes, sir.
Communication में क्या है? Exchange of idea should happen. And if there is no exchange of idea is happening, means there is no communication is happening. There is no communication, absolutely no communication. That's why when a dog barks, it may be, suppose that you have a dog in your house. Okay, so if you have kept a dog, so both of you may have a very good relation. Sometime you also communicate, okay, Tommy naam hai, jo bhi naam hai, Tommy sit down. The dog doesn't understand that you are saying to sit down. Dog understands only the voice. It is a kind of a conditioning. You must have studied about the conditioning in the B.Ed. During the B.Ed.
Yes, it is a conditioning. Yes,
dog is not understanding that you are saying sit down, and that's why the dog is sitting down. Even dog barks when the dog sees you. Are you able to understand? No. But you understand that when you are going out of the house, so you understand that dog is showing a love to you. When the dog tries to hug you or something like that. Or when the strange person is coming and when the dog barks, no one understands what the dog is saying. But you understand, okay, so there is a strange person, that's why the dog is barking. But there absolutely no communication is happening because the exchange of idea is not happening. Why the exchange of idea is not happening? Both the party is trying to exchange the idea. You and your dog, both are trying to exchange the idea. But due to the difficulty in understanding the code, decoding, so decoding bolte hain, that we will see. Due to the difficulty in decoding the code, you are not understanding and there is no communication happening. Like that, if I will start speaking Malayalam, you will be not able to decode. So that is. So the code chosen must be very much appropriate in nature. You must be very sure that which kind of a code will be appropriate for this audience, in this context, in this concept that I am trying to communicate. Everything you cannot communicate in the written form. Suppose that how much happy you were, you cannot communicate with the text. The degree of happiness. How the degree of happiness can be communicated? By the seeing the person or through a video. When you will see, listen the verbal expression, non-verbal expression, gesture, posture, facial expression, voice modulation, everything. Then you can understand the depthness of a happiness or the depthness of a sadness. So every type of communication cannot happen in every code. Code must be chosen very appropriately. I don't know to which extent it is significant to talk it here, but just remember, because when I was a student, so many people were in the relationship. So sometimes झगड़ा हो जाता था. झगड़ा क्यों, मैं ये हमेशा mention करता हूँ. झगड़ा का रीजन क्या होता था दोनों में, बिकॉज दे वेर टॉकिंग ओवर फोन बाई द चैट. सो चैट में ओनली द टेक्स्ट विल गो, इमोशन विल नॉट गो. सो इफ द इमोशन विल नॉट गो, देन यू विल फाइंड डिफिकल्टी इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग व्हाट द पर्सन इज सेइंग. इमोशन इज नॉट गोइंग ना. लाइक दैट यू मस्ट हैव सीन अ मूवी. विच मूवी? हाँ, वो क्या था, पीके, आमिर खान वाला. सो पीके वाज एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट द सेम वर्ड इज एक्सप्लेन्ड इन अ वेरियस कॉन्टेक्स्ट. जैसे बोलेंगे अच्छा इज समथिंग, अच्छा दिस इज सम अदर मीनिंग, अच्छा दिस इज सम अदर मीनिंग. सेम वर्ड इज यूज्ड but with the expression it is giving a different meaning. So the code is very much important, and how that code will be sent, that is also important. Just few time back I was talking, if it is a face to face conversation, then you can speak. If it is a conversation with in the very large hall, then some voice modulation device you have to use. If you are sitting very far away, then some other means of communication, channel of a communication like a Google Meet or something else you have to use. Or when you are teaching in the classroom, together with your talk, some pictorial material, pictures, graphs, audio, video, you must show, so that the communication will happen in a proper way and in an effective way. Effective communication should happen. So what till now we have seen that in the process of communication, first we conceptualize. Conceptualization happens. Then, after communication, conceptualization, we choose an appropriate code to communicate. Send the code. And to send the code, we choose an appropriate medium. So, conceptualization happens. Code is chosen. Code is transmitted. Then those who, to whom you are communicating, like that I am communicating to you, so you will receive those code. My voice is coming to you? Is it coming?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
My video is also going to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Video bhi ja raha hai, audio bhi ja raha hai. So, whatever I have thought of communicating, conceptualization, whatever the code I have used, and the code is traveled to you. So now you have received the code. After receiving the code, you will try to decode it. Like that, English you can understand, so you can decode it, what I am trying to say. And after decoding, you will try to conceptualize a same thing which I intended to communicate you. I have something conceptualized and I am sending my code with a intention that after receiving and decoding, you will conceptualize the same thing which I intended to conceptualize. But just think of, is it possible to make you understand of a same degree of understanding which I am having? It is never possible. I am trying to make you understand the same degree, same level which I am having, but it won't be possible. 100% communication efficiency is never possible. It can only be possible when we will copy a file from computer to pen drive. Otherwise, it won't be possible. Why it won't be possible? I have conceptualized. I have some idea. So, idea I have coded. It may be possible that I have not coded the idea properly. I failed to properly, means as per your requirement. And in the human, it will never happen 100%. Because you are a 50 people, so 50 people have a different nature, different learning style, everything is a different, unique. And I am also not understanding you in totality. Even I don't understand my parents, my brother and sister in totality. No one can understand because we are human. So either it may not be coded properly, or it may not be sent properly, or it may not be decoded properly. Suppose that aapne Shashi Tharoor ka naam suna hai. How many of you have heard Shashi Tharoor?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Who is he?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
कांग्रेस का लीडर है. कांग्रेस का लीडर है.
अच्छा, कांग्रेस का लीडर है. कांग्रेस का लीडर अभी छोड़ दो, वो एक आदमी है. इतना बात करेंगे, पॉलिटिक्स में नहीं जाएंगे हम लोग. बिकॉज हमारा ना ये टीचिंग लर्निंग प्रोसेस में जितना हमको काम है उतना ही का एग्जाम्पल लेंगे. क्योंकि फिर कांग्रेस भाजपा बोलेंगे तो ये पॉलिटिक्स का अड्डा बन जाएगा. दैट आई डोंट वांट टू क्रिएट. सो इरिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ हिज पॉलिटिकल एफिलिएशन and his ideological affiliation, just consider Shashi Tharoor as a human. So how many of you have gone through or have listened his speech or a writing? Uska writing kabhi padha hai aapne?
Yes sir.
Yeah, uska speech kabhi suna
hai? Yes sir. Yes sir.
If you have gone through his writing, you will find he is very famous for using such a very difficult word in his writing.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And when you will go through his writing, you have to keep a dictionary. Otherwise, you won't be able to read. Because he will use such an unfamiliar word. Hena? So, what is, you are not able to decode it. The Shashi Tharoor, whatever he tried to write, he has conceptualized, he has coded, he has sent the code. How he sent the code? By the written text. Like that, this is a book. So, here also, text is coming in form of a written, sorry, code is coming in form of a written text. So, you are not able to decode it. Or you are able to decode, then your cognitive ability to understand out of that code. So many things are there. Even sometimes your psychological condition, suppose that some mishappening happened in your family. Someone is passed away or something, someone is suffering from a disease or something is there. If that time I will tell class mein baitho, sit here and learn whatever I am teaching you, your mind will be not here and you will not understand whatever I will be teaching. But if you are in a comfortable mood, nothing is there. So whatever I will tell, you will easily understand. So there are a variety of things that affects the communication. Variety of a thing is there that affects the communication. And that's why it is never possible to communicate in 100% the idea I have that will be transferred to you 100% in your mind. Means the same idea you will conceptualize by the communication process. It is practically never possible. It will be never possible practically. So, till now, what we have seen that in the communication process, first we conceptualize the idea. After conceptualizing the idea, we convert it into the codes. After converting it in the code, we send the code through a medium, through a channel. The first one is conceptualizing. Second one is coding. Third one is sending the code. How the code will be sent? Through a channel, through a medium. Then what will happen? There is a receiver who will receive a code. After receiving a code, they will decode it. After decoding of code, they will try to conceptualize the idea. So this is the whole process of communication. So when we talk with each other, we have never thought ki ye baatcheet karne mein itna sara process hota hai. Have you thought ever? How many of you have thought that this much process happens when I talk with each other? Kitne logon ne aisa socha tha? Anuradha, have you thought of this? That this much process happens when you used to talk? Anuradha, are you here? No. क्या किया इधर लॉग इन करके चले गए आई डोंट नो प्रमीला साहू आर यू हियर हैव यू थॉट दैट दिस मच प्रोसेस हैपेंस व्हेन यू टॉक टू ईच अदर
नो सर आई नेवर थॉट दैट लाइक दिस प्रोसेस इज कमिंग इन आवर माइंड दिस प्रोसेस इज कमिंग इन आवर माइंड व्हेन एक्चुअली
दिस हैपेंस
व्हेन इट अप व्हेन इट थॉट व्हेन इट अप
So this happens.
Yes, sir.
So this is the communication process. But when the communication will be there will be a barrier in communication. Barrier means which will restrict the communication process. Barrier means क्या होता है suppose that you are protesting somewhere तो protest करते हैं तो क्या करता है पुलिस वहां पे एक barrier लगा देता है barrier means police is restricting you to proceed further हाँ so here also there is a barrier which restricts the process of communication so in the next class we will see what is the restriction What are the different type of a restriction? All those things we will see. Hai na? Here it is also there in the syllabus to study about the mode, principle, concept and the barrier. So till now I have taught only the concept of communication. What is the concept? I think, have you studied the communication concept? Have you understood?
Yes sir.
So any question till now? Any question, any doubt, any clarification you require? No question. Please remember because now all students have been admitted, that's why I am repeating. in my class, a lecture will be not there like that. I will be speaking for one hour and you will be listening passively. You have to ask question, you have to talk. Since it was a recapitulation class, that's why I had spoke for the whole class duration, but you have to speak in my class. That is more important, and that is the modality of teaching in a higher education.
Yes, sir.
Sir, I have one doubt.
Okay. So you have to ask a question.
Sir, I have one doubt, sir.
Achha, yes, sir. Meena Ketan.
Sir, you have told yes, that in a communication yes, process, sir, we can't share our feeling by text chat. Communication process, but nowadays, sir, we frequently use some emojis when we chat on WhatsApp and Facebook and Messenger.
Sir, I hope, sir, and Facebook and Messenger.
Receiver who send the message, he will understand the feelings the message by through the emojis.
He will understand the feelings,
sir, it is
by through the emojis.
Sir, okay. Meena Ketan, you are right, but
sir,
just tell me one question,
some extent.
That if you are happy,
sir, I think it is up to some extent.
Yes, Rituparna, it is up to some extent, because that same thing I was saying, suppose that you are happy, so you are sending an emoji of a happiness, okay, but the other person can understand that you are happy, but the degree of happiness they cannot understand. How they can understand the degree of happiness?
Sir,
I may be also happy, so I will send the emoji. You may be more happy than me, so you will also send same emoji. The degree of happiness cannot be sent through
emoji. Sir, reality and imagination bitre difference to se hai na. Suppose ame practically gote loko ko dekhi jani pare se kete khushi achi kete
practically gote
sad achi. But practically pojon ta ame no dekhi se pojon ta ame guess kori pare je se kete khushi achi kete nai. Eta bi gote reality and imagination bitre gote gap bi rouchi.
Reality and imagination with a gap. So, yes, face-to-face interaction is more effective. We can see their facial expressions.
When you will interact, then that will be more effective. Last class yesterday I was talking about why it is necessary to take the student to the real life situation. I was giving one example of taking the student to the Puri sea beach. If you are teaching about the sea beaches and a sea, but if it is not possible, then some alternate medium like showing a video or something you can use, but it will be always preferable to take to the real life situation where they can interact. But it is not always possible due to the certain restrictions, constraint. That's why we are using the tools of ICT. Kruti Ranjan, anything from your side?
No, sir.
Okay. So, I think this is already at the end of time. So, shall we stop this class here?
Yes, sir.
But I will request you, please fill the Google form that I have sent to you as soon as possible.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.